Hello, everyone. Thank you so much for being here present with us in this conversation that Protocols.io will be having with Dr. Diogo Coelho to discuss his lab protocol article and the associated protocol in Protocols.io entitled Testimony on a Successful Lab Protocol to Disrupt Chlorella vulgaris microalga cell wall. Diogo, thank you so much for sparing some time to talk to us.
Thank you for the opportunity to explain a little more about this protocol and give you some additional details.
So before we begin, let me introduce you. So Dr. Coelho is a geneticist and biotechnologist with a PhD in veterinary sciences with specialty on biological and biomedical sciences. Diogo received his degree in 2022 from the University of Lisbon, and he's currently a postdoctoral fellow of the project Extratoteca in the Center for Molecular and Environmental Biology and in the University of Minho. Diogo has published 24 peer-reviewed articles, 2 book chapters, and has 2 provisional patents. At the moment, he's also a co-supervisor of 2 undergraduate students. He works in the area of veterinary and natural sciences with emphasis on biological sciences, biotechnology, biochemistry, and pharmacology. His main areas of interest are the development of different strategies, including enzymatic approaches, to disrupt the micro and microalgae cell walls, and its subsequent incorporation on pig and poultry diets in order to improve the algae nutritional value, feed efficiency, and animal meat quality. Recently, he is focused on the study of pharmacological properties of microalgae extracts. Diogo, thank you very much again.
Thank you.
So let's dig into the paper. So can you briefly explain to us what the protocol is about, how to use it, and why it is relevant?
So this protocol presents a methodology developed to disrupt the cell wall of these microalgae, Chlorella vulgaris, and also to assess the degree of this disruption. So therefore, it presents a set of steps that involve the evaluation of a set of enzymes or mixtures of enzymes in terms of their capacity to degrade the cell wall of these microalgae, as well as the evaluation of the stage of this disruption. Since the project we were working on involved the development of enzyme mixtures with the capacity to degrade the cell wall of this microalgae, the Chlorella vulgaris, this protocol was developed and implemented to respond to that need. And hence its relevance for us and for the general scientific community.
Can you tell us when you decided to develop this protocol? What was the state of the art? In other words, why previous protocols in this area didn't work for you?
So for us, it was necessary to identify the enzymatic mixture with the greatest capacity and ability to disrupt the cell wall of this microalgae. And in our opinion, the protocols, the published protocols, were either incomplete in the evolution step of the disruption of the cell wall of this microalgae. And the most complete ones use the technologies that were not immediately available to us, like electronic microscopy. So therefore, it was necessary to develop and optimize a complete protocol like this. To respond to that need, so the most important step for us was not only the to promote the disruption of the cell wall, but also try to evaluate with a high level of accuracy the disruption of these microalgae. And the published protocols were not so complete in this part, but the previous published protocols were precious for us, like a starting point to start to optimize this protocol, this more complete protocol.
And I bet that you invested quite some time into developing the protocol and get it to work. What was your motivation to finally, you know, put it into a way that you could make it public in the platform? Because that will take, you know, more time.
Yeah, but with the publication of this protocol, we make available for all scientific community that works in that field of microalgae and microalgae cell wall disruption using different technologies and strategies. So we make available a set of scientific output with a peer review process, which is very important for other researchers, that was not full optimized before, but now we have a complete protocol that suffer a peer review process, and now it's available for all the scientific community using technology that it's not so expensive, and everyone can do this and obtain the results that we obtain.
And speaking of peer review, can you tell us how the peer review feedback that you receive from PLOS ONE shaped the final version of your protocol?
The feedback that we received from the peer reviews, it was always in the sense of make the steps of this protocol as clear as possible, so that anyone in this field can pick it up and carry out this protocol without any problems. So the peer review process was very important to make this protocol very clear, all the steps with the scientific content, with the most scientific content that was possible, and in the clear way that can make everyone available to perform this protocol.
And I would like us to move now into the protocol itself and talk a little bit more about it. So is there anything that you tried while you were developing the protocol that didn't work and didn't make it to the final version of the protocol? Are there any significant negative results?
No, in the way that all the steps that we think about are in the protocol, are represented in the protocol, but every particularly all require a big process of optimization to put that on the protocol, but every steps that we think are in the protocol.
And have you encountered any case of a need to troubleshoot? I, at one point, was an experimentalist myself, and something, my protocol that used to work regularly, eventually, if I change a reagent or the temperature of the room dropped a little bit, the protocol will stop working. Is there anything similar to that? Have you had to troubleshoot it? And if so, how and why?
Yes. Like in the step one of this protocol, we introduce a microalgae pre-wash step, because without this step, the controls, mainly in the DNS assay, add a lot of signal. And therefore, the pre-wash step is essential to balance these controls, probably due to some impurities on the microalgae powder. Moreover, the entire HPLC methodology has also been greatly optimized to make it possible to separate monosaccharides from oligosaccharides all the mobile phase, the concentration of standards and the concentration of the samples have to be a lot of have to suffer a lot of optimization to work. But the biggest troubleshooting that we have was the introduction of a pre-wash step that is very important for the protocol, because it's the first step of the protocol. So you have to perform it very well to have a good methodology process.
So can you reiterate, in addition to step one, which is critical, what other steps in the protocol are fundamental for the success?
The step one involves, like, the pre-wash, the incubation steps with the microalgae suspension with enzymes, individual enzymes or a mixture of enzymes. This step is very important because it's where the disruption of the microalgae cell wall occurs. So you need to, it's the mainly step of this protocol. You need to perform it very well. It's very critical for the rest, the protocol, because it's, well, it starts and you obtain your material to evaluate the disruption degree in the following steps. So this incubation step is very important to perform it well.
And I mean, I know that the protocol was developed to work with a specific species of algae. Where do you see the protocol evolving? How easily do you think it can be implemented to different species of microalgae?
Yeah, this is a very important question, because this protocol is optimized for Chlorella vulgaris, because the cell wall composition, it's different between microalgae species, and these enzymes, this mixture of enzymes that we optimized in this protocol, it's indicated for the cell wall of Chlorella vulgaris. If you want to implement this protocol in the disruption of other microalgae species, you need to change your enzymatic mixture. You need to search other enzymatic activities. But the good notice, the good news is that you can use all other steps to evaluate this disruption of the other microalgae species. But it's essential to change your enzymatic activities.
And because the platform has a fork function, it is very easy for any user to come, make an editable copy, and then just change the steps that need to be optimized for a different species, and keeping the rest of the steps constant, as you just mentioned.
Yeah, after the work is done.
And so, and before we wrap up, I would like you to discuss. It's, to me, it's always a pleasure to talk to young scientists like you. What has been the significance for your career of getting this additional protocol peer-reviewed as a standalone publication?
Well, since the identification of the enzymatic mixtures with the capacity to degrade the Chlorella vulgaris cell wall was the initial step of my PhD project, this protocol was fundamental to starting point for carrying out my PhD, and also allowed me to acquire a lot of knowledge in the area of enzymatic reactions, enzymatic degradation of cell walls of microalgae and microalgae biology. So this protocol was like the starting point for my career as a researcher. So it was very important.
I think you're touching a very interesting point, because I think that all young scientists, whenever they start a project, in this case, you know, a PhD thesis, probably the first year or 2 years of research is actually getting a protocol to work for their new conditions. And that is usually lost that information, that work is lost. And best case scenario, it's summarized as one or two sentences in the materials and methods section. But with this partnership between protocols.io and plus one, that work can actually fruitfully be reflected in the production of a paper.
Yeah,
right. And then the community can benefit from all that work because the details of the development and optimization of the protocols are reported.
Yeah. As I said, there's some processes, some experiments that you need to do it, but you don't know how because there's no protocol with all the information and with all the steps that you can follow in and obtain your results. So I think a good way to start, it's okay, let's optimize a protocol. Let's starting a protocol. Let's construct this methodology. And then it's very important to make it available for other research because this is not a competition. This is we need to do science. No science need to be in your favor. We have to be in the way of science and not the science in the way of us.
And
it's very important to help other research. And here, even you have not all the steps, but if you have half of steps and some process under construction, it's a very help way to start something.
Yes. Sorry. Science is a collaborative enterprise.
Of course. Yeah.
And before we really finish, is there anything that you would like to add to this conversation that we haven't mentioned yet?
No, I think we touched in the most important points of this protocol. I can show to you that this is an important way to start a project, not only your PhD, but a research project that you are working on. And it's not easy to work in this area, in this field, because there's a lot of information that we need to acquire, and the composition of the cell walls of microalgae is not totally known. And this is an impairment for us because it's very important to know your composition of your microalgae to choose your enzymes and enzymatic activities. So it's like a shot in the dark. And but it's a very pleasant field to working on. And I think I can give to you this perspective.
Well, thank you very much, Diogo. It's been a really fun conversation, and I know it's going to be useful for the users of the protocol. So with that, I will bid farewell, and really nice talking to you.
Thank you.